MedCram.com.
Okay, well, welcome to another MedCram.com board vitals question. This one comes from the US Emily Step 1 and Comlex Part 1 Banks. A 26-year-old male developed worsening weakness in his legs for the last 5 months. He noticed that running and walking was becoming increasingly difficult. He does not have any chronic diseases and has not sustained any injuries to his body. Deficiency of which of the following enzymes is most likely? You've got A, glycogen synthase, B, debranching enzyme, C, branching enzyme, D, acid maltase, or E, glucose 6-phosphatase. So you know what they're looking for here. They're looking for basically, do you understand your glycogen storage disease? So let's take a look here at the glycogen storage diseases. So I've got them listed. There's about 8 of them. Actually, there's 9 if you can count the 0. Each glycogen storage disease is a problem with an enzyme in the process of making the glycogen and specifically storing it. So there's only one that's actually for making glycogen, and all the other ones are storing it. So what happens is the glycogen accumulates in the liver, and it can accumulate in different compartments, and that causes different problems. Interestingly, type 0, which is very rare, is a problem with actually making it. And so what happens is that the liver is actually pretty small in these cases, and it's actually quite mild. But all of the other ones that you would be tested on is 1 through 8. And let's go through those. So there's von Gierke, which is a problem with glucose 6-phosphatase. And this is pretty severe. They usually have problems very early in life. There's liver enlargement because of the storage of the glycogen. And the glucose is very, very low, pretty severely low. So these people have problems very early on. That's one of the things that you'll see with von Gierke's disease. Pompe's disease, which I have here in red, is a problem with maltase, and it's an alpha-1-4, alpha-1-6 glucosidase. And the key to remember with this is it is number 2, and there are 2 types. There's a pediatric and there's an adult type. The pediatric is pretty severe, and they're usually dead by 2 from cardiomyopathy, and all organs are affected because of this. With the adult, however, there is less of a deficiency, and they actually do fine up until later in life, maybe 20s or 30s, and what they start to get is lower extremity weakness, which sounds familiar here, right? So there's less of an accumulation. And what you'll see is you'll see these lysosomes in the cells that are full of this stuff. So lysosomal accumulation is key for Pompe's disease, which is type 2. And remember, there are 2 types of the type 2. There's pediatric and adult. Cori is the debranching enzyme. It's a milder form of type 1, whereas Anderson is a branching enzyme, and it's very severe. So think of the branching as severe, and the debranching is not so severe. I don't know if it'll be helpful to memorize amylo 1,6-glucosidase for the debranching or alpha-1,4, alpha-1,6 for the branching, but you may need to know these, although Cori and Anderson are probably not tested as often. One that is, however, is Mcardle's disease, phosphorylase. You should know that they just get muscle cramps, not really weakness, just some muscle cramps. So we're seeing a big diversity here. With HERS, it's also phosphorylase, but it's a much milder form of type 1. And phosphofructokinase is very similar to type 5, which we've got up here. And then finally, phosphorylase kinase, again, it's like type 1. You do have an enlarged liver. You do have decreased glucose like you do in type 1, which we have here, but it's also a milder form. So really the key highlights here is that you've got to know that there's an adult form. And that adult form is type 2, which has the maltase. So now if we go back and look at the question, we will see what we've got is a 26-year-old male with worsening weakness in his legs for the last 5 months. That makes us think about Pompe's disease. And here we're seeing that there's running and walking, which is becoming increasingly difficult. He does not have any chronic diseases, so this is not a patient that would fit into, for instance, type 1, okay? And he's not sustained any injuries to his body. So which enzyme are we looking at? So the glycogen synthase, remember that was type 0, and that one's pretty mild. They don't get liver enlargement. The debranching enzyme was actually the more milder one. Let's take a look at that one again. So here with debranching, that's the Cori or the amylo 1,6-glucosidase. That's a milder form of type 1, but that's usually something that pops up pretty early and you get liver enlargement and decreased glucose. We're not seeing that with this patient. Then the other one, which was right below that in the answer question, was branching enzyme. And typically we're seeing cirrhosis by the age of 2. That's clearly not the question stem that we're seeing. So the next one is this acid maltase, which is, of course, the alpha-1-4, alpha-1-6 glucosidase, and that's the Pompes, that's the pediatric and adult onset. And that does go along with this, at least the 26-year-old male part does. What about glucose-6-phosphatase? Let's take a look at that one. 6-phosphatase, the glucose-6-phosphatase here, that one's going to cause liver enlargement and severe decreased glucose. So after we look at all of these, the one that makes the most sense is D, which is the acid maltase. And again, what is it that you need to know? You need to know the enzymes that are involved. You need to know the clinical syndromes that are involved. And I would not focus on the syndromes that are very similar to each other, which there are a lot of. What I would focus on are the things that are very unique. And of course, Pompe is probably out of those the one that is the most severe that you would see in an adult. And of course, they're going to probably test you on that because they're going to want to make sure that you can identify that. So the right answer here is D, acid maltase. Thanks for joining us.